Hey, what's up? My name is Alex. I'm a music producer, and today I'm gonna do a reaction to Enemy from the Arcane TV series, composed by Imagine Dragons and JIT. Man, I'm so proud of Imagine Dragons, by the way. I remember when they released their first EP and they were not so huge, and then just they took the world by storm, and now they're writing opening music for one of the biggest games ever made and also one of the most popular Netflix shows ever made, Arcane. I don't know much about League of Legends. I just watched 3 episodes of Arcane. I listened to the song once, but lots of you have been asking me to just do a reaction analysis video about it, so let's just go. I wake up to the sounds of the silence that allows for my mind to run around with my ear modern production. I'm searching to be elements, the stories that I told when my back is to the world. I like this sound design they have. I feel like, you know, Dan is the lead Imagine Dragon singer, is soaring on top. A sound design that sounds kind of putrescent and kind of like, you know, dirty and stuff, which I think is a reflection of the area where the protagonists live. Like, they're living basically in the slums, in the dirt, and I think the track is representing that with the sound design. Just listen to the sounds. Wake up to the sounds of the silence that allows for my mind to run around with my ear up to the ground. Man, I love how much his voice kind of travels throughout different octaves. Yeah, so basically, everybody wants to be my enemy. See, this is kind of what I mean. Like, it goes, everybody wants to be my enemy. Like, it goes up and down the octaves super quickly and super naturally. And also, I really like the brass stabs that go together with the sort of like hip-hop beat. It gives a very gangsta vibe. It makes me think of a way more subtle version of like Stand Clear by Mop. You know, that sort of gangsta sound, but in that case, it's super strong. In here, it's more subdued, it's more subliminal, maybe to represent the fact that this song is written from the perspective of someone that has not fully developed yet, in a way. Like, they haven't gone full gangsta yet, but there's some of that vibe in them, in this whole context. Look out for yourself, my enemy. And this sound design, super cool. Sounds very dark. Your words up on the wall as you're praying for my phone. And the but what I like is that despite being like a sort of like gangsta track, it doesn't feel too much like Dan from Imagine Dragons is singing without melody. Like, one thing that is happening very frequently in rap music nowadays is that there's not a lot of melody in the way people rap. It's like, what is this? Like, but here we are with Imagine Dragons singing on top of a hip-hop beat in a way that is very interesting, melodic, and enticing to listen to without those school in the background. I feel like a freaking boomer talking about rap music like this, but rap music today is not the same that it was when I grew up, and I think it's for worse, to be honest. But, you know, that's just me with my nostalgia goggles. Let's move on. Wow, I love the harmonies. Like, you can feel the torment. Wow, that was super cool. Sorry for stopping every 5 seconds, but the vocals of Dan, they're filled with so much detail. First, the way he sings so freaking high with that sort of like rough, raspy voice feels very tormented. But underneath that, there's one voice that does this. One voice does that. Tell you you're the greatest. And when you put them all together, tell you you're the greatest. But once you turn the haters, it's sort of like a lament almost that follows the main vocals. There's this haunting harmonic vocals a bit everywhere. A metaphor for the protagonist, followed by their inner demons everywhere. Wherever they go, they have this inner anxiety, anguish that follows them everywhere. And what I like the most is how this ends. It almost sounds like a Queen song now with those super big vocals. Very, very beautiful way to build up to probably the next chorus. I love the way they design those brass stabs, because whenever they play, like those bam, bam, you also feel Dan chanting, and that adds to the sort of like gangsta street vibe, which is super cool. Oh, the misery. Everybody wants to be my enemy.
available. I'ma tell him my silhouette go.
Oh, this is pretty cool, actually. Wow. He's killing it. And it matters more because damn. I had a thought about wreaking havoc on an opposition. Kind of shocking. They want a static with precision. I'm automatic. Quarterback, I ain't talking second. Pack it up on batter up. Who the baddest? It don't matter because we just. Wow. Okay, that was cool. That was better than the modern hip hop I hear nowadays. When you hear people rap like this, one thing you have to keep in mind is that it's extremely hard to sing in rhythm like that. Not only because you run out of breath, but also it's so freaking hard to keep the rhythm precisely like that, like a freaking machine. So that is super freaking cool. This is a very sort of like introverted track. I feel like it has a lot more to say, and you can extrapolate so much more musicality and value out of it if you wanted to by arranging it. For example, my friend Around Zero just did this. So yeah, so it's a pretty nice song. It's reminiscent of a style of hip-hop music that is slowly dying, at least in my point of view. Maybe I'm out of the loop and there's lots of songs being produced like this, but I don't know. That was a bit of a breath of fresh air. Still, I think that this track has a lot more to say, so I would not be surprised if in the next seasons of Arcane or something like that, they're gonna take this and arrange it in a huge way or whatever. I know Samuel Kim already did like a epic orchestral arrangement, which I suppose is gonna be a freaking banger the moment I listen to it. So I feel like this track has a lot more to give. We just have seen the tip of the iceberg. It's a pretty cool track. I wouldn't say that it just blew my freaking mind beyond imagination, but it's a fresh piece of music, which I understand why lots of people are listening to and appreciating. But if you like this stuff, I recommend you to check out hip-hop music of the early 2000s or the 90s. You're gonna find loads of surprises that are gonna blow your freaking mind, because that is where this sort of style came from. Anyway, I'll leave you with that. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.